What's going on, guys? My name's Bruce. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to show you how to clone yourself, but with the camera moving. Now, I'll cut straight to the point with this one. You're going to need either a gimbal, which you can automatically set waypoints on, a slider, or some kind of rotation device, which has a constant speed. If you don't have any of those, then there is an alternative way to create a similar effect, which I am going to discuss in a future video. So make sure you subscribe to see that. Now, this effect is all in the planning and shooting. There is essentially very little editing involved, other than choosing the clips that best match up and then some simple masking. Therefore, you can create this effect in pretty much any NLE of your choice, but today I'll be using Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's get straight on with it. Right, so the way this effect works is you're taking a moving video of yourself in one position, then taking another moving video of yourself in a different position. If the movement, speed, location of the camera and the background are the same in each video, then when you stack one clip on top of the other, they should match up. All you then need to do is mask out the parts of the video which cover where you're stood. Now, my gimbal is the Ronin SC. Within the app, it allows you to set waypoints. You can set movement duration and the stay time, allowing the gimbal to automatically move in the same direction and at the same speed for each take. I set my duration to 5 seconds between each waypoint and my stay time at 0, meaning it didn't stop at each location and was a continuous movement. I won't go into depth on how I did this with my particular gimbal, as it will vary on the equipment you use, but if you have the Ronin SC, or a feature like this on yours, then give it a try and see what works best for you. So this is how you can get consistent movement in each shot and create this effect. This is also how the big studios do it, except they use an arm or a track. Like I said, the planning and shooting is the most important part. Therefore, I'll go about showing you how I plan this effect in my notes on my phone, from the props I used, outfits I wore, locations I stood, plus anything I needed to consider when shooting. So, Christmas clone. Props, beers, antlers, Christmas hat, tinsel, headphone plus iPhone adapter, Christmas cracker. Now, you've seen the video, so this is pretty self-explanatory. Shot list, blue jumpers. Now, I'll get into why I've separated the shots of the blue jumpers and the green jumpers later on. Shot one, me walking into the kitchen, putting on headphones, looking into the camera, then tapping on my phone screen. Once the camera has panned around and stopped, press on phone screen again, take off headphone plus exit the kitchen. Now, I wasn't actually tapping on my screen to start the rotation. The gimbal was set up to rotate automatically. The reason I tapped on my screen is because I wanted to simulate starting the song. Other than that, the rest is also self-explanatory. So shot one is essentially the final shot too. Because the camera is doing a 360, I needed to make sure I was in the same position at the start and at the end of the video. Therefore, I set the camera to record extra time at the end of the rotation for me to take my headphones off and walk out. Two, me with antlers on plus beer in hand, pretending to talk to clone on chair. This was me stood by the TV pretending to have a conversation with a clone at the table. Three, me sat at the table with a Christmas hat on eating. I needed to fit a few clones of me in the video and this felt like a good place to put one. Four, me by wall offering clone to pull Christmas cracker. This was me stood by the wall asking my clone if he wanted to pull the cracker. Green jumpers, me sat on chair looking at antler clone while nodding head with beer in hand. So in this one, I was pretending to look up at the clone in shot two and agreeing with what he was saying. Two, me stood looking into mirror and putting tinsel around my neck. Pretty self-explanatory. Three, me being offered to pull cracker by blue clone and declining while holding beer. Here I'm pretending to interact with the clone from shot four and declining the offer of pulling the cracker. Considerations. Now, this is where the planning and preparation really take place and will determine how well you pull off this effect. Stand blue green, etc. To add another level of detail to this effect, I changed the jumper I was wearing between each clone. This works even better when two clones are interacting as it creates a separation of the subjects while still maintaining the illusion of it being the same person. Shoot all the blue jumpers first, then the green. Okay, so the reason this effect works is because everything in each take is exactly the same, apart from where I'm stood, of course. So any movement of the camera or any inconsistencies between each clip will show up when you try to match them up in editing. Therefore, once you've set your camera plus gimbal up, you can't touch it until you're finished. So why the blue jumpers first, you're probably asking. Okay, so I shoot with the A6500 and battery life is not one of its strong points. I had approximately 20 to 25 minutes or so of shooting in 4K to get the whole thing done. Changing jumpers between each take is just not a very good use of time, and it would have probably taken me over one battery had I not done it this way. The first shot is also the last shot, as I explained before. Make the spin 20 seconds long. Now, this won't apply to your video, but I had already found the song I was going to use and knew the amount of time I had to complete the effect. The chorus of the song was about 20 seconds, so I knew if I set the gimbal to take 20 seconds to complete a full rotation, I could start and stop on the beginning and end of the chorus. Set white balance and keep consistent, not auto. I've said this enough times already, but everything needs to be kept the same. White balance is something that can change if you set it to auto, although very unlikely if you're in a controlled environment like inside. But it's best to do it anyway. You also want to set your white balance to incandescent if you're inside, or use a grey card like I usually do. Use large aperture to avoid depth of field. Another thing that can break consistency is the amount of bokeh, or background blur, between each clip. Now, I like to shoot a lot of my videos on a wide aperture, like my Sigma 16mm is a 1.4, and it creates really nice bokeh. The problem with shooting this wide though is if I'm stood closer to the camera in one take than I am in the rest, the background will be blurry in that take and then they won't match up. It didn't matter too much in my case, but it's definitely something to remember if you've got subjects closer to the camera in some takes than others. If speaking to clone, make sure only one is talking at a time. Keep eye level if looking conversing with clone. These points are both about making it look natural. I needed to pre-plan which clone was talking and which was listening. If both were talking at the same time, it would just look unnatural. Something else to bear in mind is keeping line of sight accurate. When we talk to people, we usually look at their eyes. So when I played the clones interacting with each other, I made a reference of where my head was so I could look at that point when I was the opposing clone. Do not move anything, plus keep everything consistent between each shot. Tables, chairs, doors, lights, or sky, cars, people if you're outside, all these things can change, and if they're not consistent between each take, then again, you won't get the result you want. Do not move, touch the camera. Just like the background, the camera can't move either, other than by the gimbal automatically. If I was to even nudge the position of the camera or gimbal, it could throw the whole alignment off and the clips won't line up. This is why I had to get it done on one battery, as changing it on my gimbal meant taking the camera off, thus throwing off the alignment. Right, so now let's jump into Premiere Pro and I'll show you how I made this effect. Okay guys, we're inside of Premiere Pro and this is going to be my quick example of how to put these clips together. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go through all your clips and find the, you know, videos that you're the most happy with. These were the ones that I chose. These were the ones I actually used for the video. So this is me putting on the headphones. This is me stood by the TV with a beer in my hand. And then this is me sat down, nodding and agreeing with the one who's supposed to be stood here. Okay, so I was the most happy with those three clips. Now, the way to actually make this effect work is you essentially just need to stack this clip on top of this clip. Now, because I shot these clips, everything exactly the same, all set from my gimbal, same duration, same speed, same everything. The video clips are the same length and the start time is the exact same time, which means at this point here in the video on this clip will be the same position at this point here on this clip. So if I toggle the eye visibility off on this one, you'll see it's the same position. It's not perfect, as you can see, it's not completely aligned, but that's because I'm using a gimbal and it's not completely accurate, but it's close enough, and with some masking and some feathering, you can actually hide that. So the way to actually get yourself in both the clips at the same time, if you've done masking and cloning before on still shots, you already know about this, but if you don't, I'll just quickly show you. You need to add a mask to this clip here. So here's the pen tool. To do a quick simple mask, and now you can see I'm in both of these at the same time, like that. All you would then do is you would animate the path of the mask. So there's the animation tool, we'll move this across like that, and then we'll move the mask over like that, and then we'll move it over there, and then we'll move it over there, and we'll just go like this, and we'll go back this way like that until I'm completely off the screen. Something like that, maybe. This is very rough. This Steve only got an idea of how it works. And then when you play this back, you've got yourself in both of the clips at the same time. Now, that does look good, but there is one obviously thing that sticks out, and that's this line here. Now, the reason this line is created is because the alignment of the videos are not exactly the same. The movement of the gimbal was not exactly the same. And the way to hide that is so simple. You just need to crank up the feather to something ridiculous, like let's just, you know, 600. And now you can see, yes, it's a bit blurry here, but it's not something most people are going to notice. If I toggle that sort of on and off, you'll see the microwave, a little bit of distortion, possibly in the cupboard. But then if I play this, I'm now in both of those clips at the same time. And you do exactly the same thing for the third clip. Again, stack this clip on top of here, and then I do a mask on this video, and then I'm in both of those videos at the same time. Once you've done that, the effect you get with those three is this. Okay, to give you a quick demonstration of those masks in action, this is the whole video that I made. So these are all the clips stacked up with the masks applied. And if I just scrub through and switch off the individual layers, so now you've just got this layer by itself. That's the mask of that one. Turn that one off, turn this one on. That's the mask of that one. Turn that one off, turn that one on. That's the mask of that one. And then it just goes on for each one. Like there, and then there, and then finally the last one, there. Now, something to bear in mind as well is you don't want to have yourself cross paths with the other clone. So something that was quite close here was the tinsel that came down was very, very close to my head in this one, and I had to do a very close mask. Something you don't want to do is make the tinsel cross over, because you're going to give yourself a lot more work when it comes to masking. It is possible to work around it, but it's just something I try to avoid. And there you go, guys, that is the whole effect. I hope you enjoyed that, guys, and you learned something. I'll link the footage I use in the description below so you can have a go yourself. If you have any questions or requests on any other effects you want me to break down, leave them in the comments below. But thanks anyway, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.